People are not blind.
We don't fault you.
But So that is where to justify their foolish religion.
So
for what see? That's why there is a problem now. But what we have seen here is God unflinching, that is, always there for you in time of trouble. That's why you need to draw nearer. Look at Deuteronomy chapter 33. Deuteronomy chapter 33. In verse 27. 33 verse 27. Eternal God is thy refuge, and under him are the everlasting arms. He shall thrust out the enemy from before thee, and shall say, destroy them. That's the promise of God for every child of God. That is everlasting arm of God is underneath us. And that is our refuge, eternal God. Not your business.
Some
of you are giving me excuses. I can't serve God because of my business. Can't do that right now.
Some
of you are telling me, it's very difficult to obey the Bible. Cancel it now and serve God with all your heart. Because in time of trouble, you need God. Look at David. If not that he was really a prayer man, you can see Saul would have caught him red handed. In Psalm 9, verse
9.
The Lord also will be a refuge for your prayers, a refuge in time of trouble. God is ready to protect you from Satan. Look, it's time you disconnect, get out of all this wrong understanding you have about God. If you don't connect with him, he can't connect with you. You need God. It's a pity. When I see believers, suffering, what I easily see in those believers is that they are not serving God the way they should serve God. Don't let anybody deceive you. If your pastor deceives you, it's you that will suffer. Even though you will die at his own time. Ordinary cough will kill you.
People,
because I've been hearing that. You see, they just carry you to the hospital before you cough. Bye-bye.
You call that song, but you better to it's cool.
Jimmy Joshua, how did he die? He had stroke, and he was struggling. By the time he went inside, they met him already dead.
Jimmy Joshua, only and some other power lesson. But your mom will only want to really go to school.
They will die at their own time.
He was there, what pull up for coats?
Their suffering will come at their own time.
But
you will suffer more.
I'm
following them. Because if you don't follow God, if you are following pastor, you won't get it right. You will not be able to pay out rent, though. You will not be able to pay the school fees of your children, though. I'm telling you, you won't get a good job, though. I'm telling you, you will be sick every day. I'm telling you, look, this one is telling you, follow the pastor, follow the word of God. Word of God. Look at Psalm 46. Look at who are hearing me all over the world. It's not about church now. It's not about pastor. It's about you and God. Look at David. If it was not him and God, Saul la winni akini.
O dadi ni biko ba se ni ko mo ti Olorun. Saul ba ti parun ati.
And all that God has planned for his life to be a king will that come to pass.
O ti Olorun ti se to fun aye re lati je oba ko ni wa si mu se.
Look at Psalm 46.
We dadi to read 46.
Psalm 46.
We dadi to read 46.
Verse 1 to verse 3.
Ese kini si keta.
God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. Therefore, we will not fear, though the heart be removed, and though the mountain be carried into the midst of the sea, though the waters therefore flow up and be troubled, though the mountain shake with the swelling thereof. Can you see? Challenges can come. Once you are with God, it's your present help.
Who
will stand by you?
He
won't leave you alone.
If you are still there.
I mean, the parents of David, they couldn't come and help him. If he had a pastor, no pastor there. It was now him and God and the enemy. And if he didn't have God, God will be looking at him like this. Look at Judas.
Judas,
even though he was very close to God, close to Jesus, but he was allowed to kill himself because he was not taken to the teaching of Jesus. He put rope around himself and hanged himself. God was looking at him. But look at Elijah. He was a serious person. Took the word of God serious. And Jesus was pursuing him. And he wanted to die. And God came. He won't die. And God gave him food to eat. Can you compare the two?
Judas,
God allowed him to die.
Allah will find a couple.
He hanged himself.
He told me from the show.
No voice. I had a case of a man. I had a case of a man.
He found a man
who was really a real child of God.
He told Allah to tell.
And then he was tired of life.
I hear it is soon.
And then he went to the bush to hang himself.
Allah see you go out to the show.
That's how God raised a minister, an
evangelist.
He went to the bush.
When he lost me, he
began to preach there.
He said,
I
was
like, I might not preach to animals.
And you know, I'm sharing our own little animals.
I'm telling you how God helps in time of trouble.
But this man,
because he's a child of God, from reading, he couldn't get good counsel. Therefore,
if you
just make up his
hand, I'm going
to kill myself.
That's
how God prays an evangelist.
That's
how
we're
preaching inside him.
That's who
he
is.
And the man begins to preach there. Give your life to Jesus. Don't die in your sin. That's how the man now says, he's God talking to me inside
the mirror. And you know, nobody's home. You know, I've been to me.
Jump inside water.
No, of course, no.
Because he was just tired.
So he soon.
Didn't get the right person to counsel him. That's why he was going to the river to one. Just die inside the water. And that's what was going. God made a madman say, go by his side. A madman, go by his side. And that's what was going. The madman was talking.
Okay, you know, what's up?
The master!
What's up?
Begin to talk!
Yes, this up.
You, I will kill myself.
Maybe you will live by me.
You, the way I am like this, I don't want to be. I won't go and drop this, I want to be. I won't.
What's your shame? I'm going to get you to go before you do that.
And the man that, God of God, he begins to listen. madman. Some people, even if you come here, you will see they are going to die inside water.
Gossip,
Because you have had the wrong, don't join them to gossip again. They will not like you.
You
have changed. You are no longer the same person anymore. Because if anybody is in Christ, a new creature. All things have passed away. You know, I was listening to an advertisement. Of glue over
everything.
And they were asking, what is Oko?
And
that's how that hooligan said, Hero Day, Oko, Oko. You know? When you are born again, you don't speak like that again.
And one man doing it, what's it?
You must change your way of talking. Talk as a child of God. Change your voice, change the way. No, you have to be very, very different from the world. If you keep doing like the world, you are not born again. So the Bible is now, Jesus now saying that because I've given them your word and you have believed your word, feel and go your but because this one, the word has hated them, there will be some special arrangement for them. Now, in verse 15, you see very well. Okay. I pray God that thou just take them out of the war, for that thou shouldest keep them from the evil. Can you see that? He has prayed for us. For children of God. Those who are born again. Those who are ready to follow by God.
Say,
God, my Father, as I'm coming to you, protect this one from evil. That's why, when temptation comes,
you can't overcome
you. Because temptation is from the devil. And God will not allow you to overcome you.
No, if I cannot believe
you. What is the small challenges you have? What you are serving God? Is it joblessness? Is it no accommodation? Is it no children? All those things. They are temptation. And God will stop the problem. And in verse 16, they are not of the world. Evil and are not of the world. So when you are dressing this as a child of God, your movement, your going here and there, let it be as a child of God. You know, God is always there to fight our battles. And all we need, He can provide. Let me read Matthew chapter 18. A lot of you, I think why some of you are born again, you're still connected to the world. It's because you're thinking that the world has something to offer you. The world has nothing to give you. God has revealed to Isaiah that this world is empty. So why are you connected to the world?
No,
let me tell you, I'm going to read something that will interest you now
too.
Matthew 28. Verse 19. Verse 18. And Jesus came and spoke unto them, saying, all power is given unto me in heaven and in earth. That's verse 18.
He was telling the disciples
that See, that Satan, he has lost everything. But the day of judgment, his judgment has not come. That everything he is doing now, Satan, is all figment. That is nothing. It's just magic he's doing.
He doesn't
have any real blessing, real progress. He doesn't have it. Yes, he has what we call FPP, that is figment of pain. Yes, he can make money. I mean, you know people now who used to make fake dollar, fake naira.
And when
you see fake naira, except you are trained, your eyes are trained in the banking environment, you can't differentiate between false dollar or fake dollar and genuine dollar. It looks like original. That's what Jesus is saying. Satan has no power in him. God has given him, after resurrection, all power in heart and heaven has been given to Jesus. So if you come to Jesus and seek him, seek the kingdom and his righteousness, when he gives you growth, that growth will last. If he gives you house, that house will last. If he gives you anything, it will last. But Satan, because he's fake, if he gives you money, you will end up in prison. Oshpopi. He got plenty of money, Oshpopi. Now, you live here for 20 years. In America. Now, Abakiari, the police officer, that himself was involved, you will see. If it is through the establishment, he said, you will land in prison. You know, Satan will give you faith. What is this thing you are pursuing? He will give you. He gave you so many people and he killed them at last. So, I'm begging you now. What? About God is common to
me.
Serve Him with all your heart. Stay truly with God.
Mami, do what you learn.
You know, in those days, when we were newly born again as children of God. So, then we believe on that. Christians must not be rich. We don't remember Abraham. We didn't remember Solomon. All the time, at that time, what we always think about, I want to put away and have the poor. Yes. I remember that. Some of you may not know this. You know, because I was a guy that I was a politician
before.
And I wear quality. I used to buy my clothes from Balogun. I don't have enough people Balogun in Lagos. That's why I get quality. Every intelligent and handsome man, woman, they know us in Lagos is Balogun. When you see what you wear, I mean, you know that these are quality people.
What down me?
So So that's why I got born again.
What is there to be?
So I had a preaching that this time was before. That I throw everything away. This one too, there's only few of you will know. In Yaba, that's the Yaba ring, what's from there, don't think.
Ni Yaba, I think that,
no. You need to come and say, popular way, you know, shit. And if you make it, if you take it, four. You can say four. New one over faith. You can say it. One naira or one foot.
Oh, sure. I'm a talent. It's only just a two. I'm a new one naira.
But the people who are producing, they know that that is the grade for poor people.
What's on the top of the way? He told you about one to see.
So that's the one that I went to buy.
He's a lot.
And you wash it once like this, color it on.
As a follower, I'm buying it. I won't have it long.
That's when we are following Jesus. You don't say so.
But you won't buy it again with your money.
If your body is not like that, they will look at you. You cannot put it.
That's
your body. Even when God prospered my big house and I bought her, I can't even see. You can't even see the house. Let's say you have to build the house.
Because
you are only.
So we can do more than one can.
You will think we don't eat. When they serve us food during the trip, I remember those days. And they want the soup with water. And that's not where I had
it.
If you better serve it, mistakenly put one meat there, they will join two of you to eat together. So when both of you are eating, none of you will take the meat. Say, bro, take it now. Then that was the thing now. That's our thing. You know what you will take that as a meat?
Holiness.
That's what we call it there. But thank God, as the Lord began to open our eyes to the Word of God, that verse began to change. Abraham was rich. He made heaven. Lazarus used to be poor. He made heaven also. And this Lazarus was even at the bosom of rich Abraham. So the choice of poverty is your own. It's not God's choice for you. What God said is seek the kingdom of God first and his righteousness and all other things shall be
added.
I thank God. God knows that we didn't understand that explanation of how to be that we should not be poor. I thank God. God did not punish me at that time. Because it is at that time God promoted me in my place of work, and we don't see any sin in that. God provided the money, they gave me the company to build house, we don't see sin. And God provided beautiful car, we don't see sin there. Thank God that God did not punish me with my
ignorance.
God will protect you.
Thessalonians
chapter 1, verse 6. Sin is a righteous thing with God to recompense tribulation to them that trouble you. God says through Paul that for anybody to hurt you and him to hurt the person, as far as he's concerned, is righteous. God said, I will fight your battle, and it is righteous to me to fight your battle. That's what he was saying.
No, no, what you are doing, that's the charity.
You must not be afraid of the power in the world. Get yourself soaked
in
God. I can assure you, no matter the challenge, you will solve the problem
for you.
Let me close with Ecclesiastes chapter 5, verse
8.
You know, what God is showing us today is this.
He
wants to draw closer to him. And that he can solve your problem. That he knows that there are problems in the world. And he knows how to solve the problem. That's what he's revealing to you today. That if he can solve the problem of David in his own way, he can solve your problem as well. Now, listen to this. Ecclesiastes chapter 5, verse 8. If thou seest the oppression of the poor and violent perverse of judgment and justice in the province, matter not at the matter. For he that is higher than the highest regardeth, and there be higher than he. You know what this verse means? That if you see a powerful man oppressing the poor, like Satan trying to fight you. Like one big man somewhere is trying to make life difficult for you. Because he's a major general or lieutenant colonel in the army. Oh, because he's a politician. God says, you don't need to be afraid of him here.
No, you know that's the way.
That he sees him. He sees him. And he's above him. He was revealing this to Solomon.
Solomon.
That is to be afraid of them. And I'm telling you this morning. If you're a child of God, is any witch disturbing your life? If you're a child of God, is any wizard disturbing your life? If you're a child of God, is any occultist disturbing your life? Or a politician? Or a rich man? Or a military man? Whoever they are, God says he's seen it all. And you don't worry yourself. I'm a child. I will silence. As long as I want to pray today, what thing you are going to say to this thing? See, what is your complaint? Hey, my business, hey, my job. Come on. Get that out of your way right now. If it's your job that will make you to be fat to God, you are going to pray today, say, God, give me a better job right now. You can't remain far away from God and that you only come to serve God when it's convenient. No, 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 it doesn't work that way. Look, here in this church, God has helped us organize it properly. You only meet in a week if you are just a member, only 2 times in a week. And if you put your number of hours together, it's not about 8 hours.
Out
of 168 hours you have in a week. So,
spend
8 hours before God is not too much.
That's
on Sunday.
The joy is
and
Thursday.
And then when we have the set meal, Lord, that comes up just through Wednesday in a week, in a month. And it's just three hours, nine to 11, 6 hours alone.
In the whole month.
And then if your job, let's say, cannot come on Tuesday, you have Android. It's okay to watch it on Android. And you must watch it. You will not be here on Tuesday. Except for a minister. We need you on Saturday here. And you just 4 hours. And then if you're a member of the choir, then take more minutes, more hours to give God. So you can practice well. Well, take Balaji. They didn't practice well this last month. You know, even one of them is sleeping. See, this is about FTSG. He's sleeping. Don't put that. You know, let us few hours to go.
You work at the day, that's enough.
So, what you tell me, who's have God?
I'm
challenging this morning.
Number
one thing you will say to me is this. God, organize my job.
So
that I can be in your presence every time.
Then
number two, God,
don't
let me love the world anyway. That doesn't mean you will hate your parents.
It doesn't
mean you not have the world. Because you still work in this world and make your money. But you will not follow their ways. And what is making you happy is being in the presence of God, not in being in no one bed. Party. That will make you happy. So when you set that now, going to prayer, you are going to pray now. What's the prayer? Lord, when I found myself in trouble, very difficult trouble, ask God for help. She is faithful help.
Wow, you will be our Lord.
We help you.
Our Lord.
We help David.
We will David in our
Lord. Help you.
Our Lord.
God is not a failure.
He
still is faithful there forever.
Oh, see what he said.
Are you having problems of getting married? Try to go to
the earth. From the dead.
Father only. But as the days of Noah were, So shall also the coming of the Son of Man be. For as in the days of the day that were before the flood, they were eating and drinking, marrying and giving in marriage, until the day that Noah entered into the ark. Verse 39. And knew not until the flood came and took them all away. So shall also the coming of the Son of Man be. Now look at our own verse 40. Then shall two be in the field, the one shall be taken, and the other left. Verse 41. Two women shall be grinding at the mill, the one shall be taken, and the other left. Verse 42. Watch therefore, for ye know not what hour your Lord doth come. That's our
own.
See, Jesus is saying, we must be waiting for the trumpet. And he says that he himself at that time, he doesn't know when the trumpet will sound. Even the angels, they don't know. It's only his Father in heaven that knows. And that's why Paul told us that now we should be waiting. The trumpet will sound, and the dead will rise in Christ first. And after that, we that are alive, we go with him. So Jesus is not warning us. You, that you are spending your time, marriage, party, every time, disco, every time. Even though you are going to jail, but everything they are doing is you want to be there. That's why he's giving the case of Noah. You have something to do in the house of God. You sit down at a party. You are taking permission every day. You are taking permission every day. That's what Jesus is saying. The trumpet comes like this. We catch you in that your party you are doing. You miss it. That's what Jesus is saying. He's not telling you not to go to where you want to go, but he said, stay there. When the trumpet sounds, hey, you are here. You will make heaven. You know how you will make heaven? Because once we are gone, and you have had a truth like this, and you know if you take 666, you are gone forever. You will be ready that they cut your hair. And then you will come and join us there. So, enjoy the party now. You won't miss heaven. Are you not following what I'm saying? I'm telling you, you are not party, you are going everywhere. I think you don't miss heaven. Means that your head will be cut when because you have had the truth already. That's the only way you will join us over there. But those of us who are here every time, seeking the face of God, when trumpets come, hey, we are gone. So the truth is, that's not for you and for me. You know, it's sad that all this, I don't know what to call these men of God all over. They don't teach people the word of God. I see what they say to us here. Tell every man of God to back away. Leave the Bible and stop confusing people. And brother, who taught? Didn't you teach people you are teaching that this one for the Israelite? Teach them? Didn't teach them? It shouldn't have had that question. Why not listening when he was teaching? See. What do I do? Do I put on a certificate? No, I'm asking you. When you teach, you teach in a way that people will understand what you're saying. So I plead with you, please, brother. When they take those time now, trumpet can sound every moment. Don't miss it. Because you see, when you miss heaven, you miss the trumpet. The trumpet,
you
will cry. Because when all the children of God are gone, you will know. Look, there was a woman. This was in
1985.
I was living at Ogudu at that time. The name of the woman is Mamaji. This woman made great restitution, which many people cannot do. She gave, you know, had two children that, you know, the children were, the parents went to take her when she was pregnant and marry her to another person. Because they said, she can't marry that man. And then when they took her there, the woman told the man that I have pregnancy.
The man
that will take it like that, don't worry. And he took the two, and when the children were to be born, they were
20.
Now, she was living with the man with his children that belonged to another man. And then when you see the children, they resemble the real father. Now, this woman met Jesus Christ when the father was still on fire. The father preached over there, and the woman got born again. He said, it's me. And then he had the message to preach restitution. Because without holiness, no man shall see God. When you want to start addressing, what the world is preaching today, even in deeper life, you will see people who need to do restitution, and you are still there. How can you go? Deeper life? You're in the second marriage, and your husband is still living, and you're in deeper life? No. Nothing happened in our day. Now, this woman, she had a message. She knew she was meant to help. She carried the twins and brought them to Lagos to give to the true man. And the husband here, who doesn't know God, began to look for the pastor that preached. Because last, wanted to kill our pastor here. And the following scene, by the time he said God back home, he died. I'm talking of fire. We are anointing is flowing. Deeper life is not there. You know this woman, when she now came to Lagos, the husband, even for people, they don't have common sense. The man was telling the woman that it is his God of his family that brought the two children. That their own children, you can't carry their children away. If the woman did not get born again, that woman, that children will belong to that
one.
But unfortunately, this woman started going back little by little. That's how one day. I was going to church, I was getting prepared there. As I was dressing, that's when the woman came to my house, our house, and began to cry. I said, what happened, sister? God showed up from 2 o'clock. God showed up, the trumpet sounded by 2 o'clock in the night. And so she thought that she had been devil. She had used the trumpet. That's why she began to cry. Because God wanted to bring her back to faith. That's why she saw the vision of trumpet. So she thought everybody has gone. That's why she went to our house early in the morning. Whether we are still around or not. And then she saw. She began to cry. I said, no, God is telling you, repent now from the evil you are into. The only thing that can happen to us, when you are not serious with God, and you are a child of God, you will receive a powerful revelation, and then you
sit down with you to see God. Because God does not want the death of sinners. The children of Israel, that's their own, they will run. Look, it's time of winter, you know that. They're talking about it. So read it again. It's talking about it. Not you. Prepare to meet your God. Repent of every sin.
You
say, like the death of Noah, they've been drinking, they've been marrying. Are you one of them? They won't think about heaven. And if you read the Bible, if you don't talk about marriage, are you not going to be careful then?
It's
like the day of Noah. They've been given in marriage.
They've
been drinking. You know what he says? Be careful about it. You shouldn't be careful. But be careful. Don't stay too long there.
I'm
going to rise up to pray now. See the trumpet sound, can you make it?
See, if we want to buy it,
can you make it? Rise up and let's pray now. And then let's look at your life. If you're not ready,
this
will prepare you now. What is in your life? What's in your life?
You're
committing fornication and adultery. Wrong marriage. You will cry.